Hi everyone, welcome to Hub Bites. I'm Sanil Rege, consultant psychiatrist. Today I'm going to take you through an antidepressant, a novel antidepressant called agomelatine. Now, agomelatine may not be available in all countries. It comes under the trade name Valdoxan in Australia. It might be known by some other names in other countries. But essentially, a lot of viewers, of course, have talked about the different antidepressants that have been prescribed. For example, SSRIs, SNRIs are the common ones that are prescribed, sometimes some tricyclic antidepressants as well. But agomelatine is a novel antidepressant with a good tolerability profile, which means obviously a lower incidence of side effects. In fact, the Cipriani meta-analysis, which is the network meta-analysis, a really, really big one comparing the different antidepressants, showed that agomelatine ranked right at the top when it came to tolerability. So why is that the case, and what are the key properties of this antidepressant? So in terms of the mechanism of action, agomelatine has two main mechanisms. One, it is a melatonin agonist. So what it does is it actually acts on M1 and M2, which are melatonin receptors. It actually activates this. Now we know, of course, that activating melatonin receptors will help in circadian rhythm regulation and promoting sleep. So that's one benefit. It does not have the antihistaminergic activity like, say, for example, mirtazapine does or amitriptyline does. So it's less likely to lead to that grogginess or sedation that some people can complain of with mirtazapine. We have done a video on mirtazapine on this channel, so do check that out. So it has this M1, M2 agonistic activity is one property. It has a second property whereby it is a 5-HT2C. This is a specific serotonin receptor. It actually antagonizes the receptor. So it is a 5-HT2C antagonist, or in other words, it blocks the 5-HT2C. Now, interestingly, the combination of these two actions results in an antidepressant property that is beneficial, which is it actually pushes dopamine and noradrenaline. In other words, dopamine and noradrenaline levels in the frontal lobe are increased. And we know that dopamine and noradrenaline are really necessary or important in a number of frontal lobe functions, such as improving hedonic drive, which is the ability to experience pleasure, focus, attention, and concentration, decision-making, and in general, improvement in mood. So by M1, M2 agonism, 5-HT2C antagonist activity, increased levels of noradrenaline and dopamine are present in the prefrontal cortex, which contributes to its antidepressant properties. In terms of its side effect profile, the main aspects that one has to look out when prescribing agomelatine is to monitor liver function tests. So when you start off at 25 milligrams at nighttime, usually prescribed at nighttime because of this property, of course, to promote sleep, liver function tests should be carried out at 3, 6, 12, and 24 weeks. If you increase the dose to 50 milligrams, which is the recommended maximum dose, again, blood tests should be done to monitor the liver function tests at 3, 6, 12, and 24 weeks. But in terms of its tolerability profile, it does not lead to sexual dysfunction because it actually antagonizes that receptor. You see, SSRIs activate this receptor, SNRIs activate this receptor and can lead to sexual dysfunction. This one blocks it, so it's actually not only can be used as a treatment for sexual dysfunction from other antidepressants, but on its own, it does not lead to sexual dysfunction, one. Two, there's no antihistaminergic property, so no weight gain. Three, no emotional blunting. Why? Because again, it does not activate the 5-HT2A receptor, which is responsible for emotional blunting. So you get a number of these properties that are beneficial. The fourth really important one is it is not associated with a withdrawal syndrome. We know SSRIs and SNRIs are notorious with regards to withdrawal syndromes. Again, we've done a video on this as well. Whilst agomelatine is not associated with a withdrawal syndrome and therefore is lower in the risk when it comes to tapering and side effects or withdrawal syndromes. So now if we look at all of these different properties, it helps, it's an antidepressant by itself. It is also in the guidelines, for example, Australian guidelines to treat anxiety. There is evidence in treatment of obsessive compulsive disorder as well. There are some case studies where it has shown some benefit in ADHD, but of course it's not a routine treatment. And in terms of its tolerability profile, sexual dysfunction minimized, withdrawal symptoms minimized, no weight gain, emotional blunting is not a side effect. It can be in fact used to treat it. So I hope that this gives you an idea about a novel antidepressant, agomelatine, that is a useful agent in treatment of depression and anxiety. If you like this video, then of course, leave us a like. Don't forget to subscribe. And of course, I look forward to seeing you in another edition of Hub Bites. Until then, take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.